My name is Lynn Yang. I'm one of the clinical pharmacists at the Heart Institute. Please turn to page 50 in your booklet as we discuss some of the new medications you have been prescribed. The objectives of this section are to review the five main medications prescribed after heart attacks and angina, review the use of nitroglycerin spray or sublingual tablets, and review tips that may help you manage your medications. Patients who have a heart attack or angina usually go home on five medications, those being ASA, an antiplatelet, an ACE inhibitor, a beta blocker, and a cholesterol-lowering medication. There are many different medications in each class, so you may be on a different drug and dose than someone else. All you need to know is that your doctor specifically chose that drug and dose based on your blood pressure, heart rate, and various other conditions that you may have. You may also be on other heart medications based on other heart conditions that you may have. These other drug classes are listed in your book. If you have questions about these other drugs, you can feel free to contact your doctor or community pharmacist. ASA, or acetylsalicylic acid, is commonly referred to by its brand name, aspirin. You will likely be taking a dose between 80 milligrams and 325 milligrams once per day. ASA helps to prevent excess clotting and has been shown to decrease the risk of future heart attacks. Because it's considered a type of blood thinner, there is an increased risk of bleeding or bruising. Signs of bleeding include throwing up what looks like black coffee grounds, blood in your urine or your stool, or black tarry stool. If you experience any of this, or if you find that you're bruising without any reason, call your doctor. You may also experience stomach upset with non-coated ASA. If you've had a heart attack or unstable angina, you will likely have been prescribed one of the antiplatelets listed here. These antiplatelets have been shown to help prevent future heart attacks. Also, if you had a stent placed in one of your coronary arteries, your body will view the stent as a foreign object and want to clot around it. So taking your antiplatelet will prevent your stent from blocking with a clot until a layer of skin grows over and covers the stent. The amount of time you need to be on this medication will depend on various factors, such as any pending surgeries and type of stent that was inserted. Your cardiologist will be able to tell you how long you will be taking this medication. If any other health professional tells you to stop taking your antiplatelet medication, it is very important that you contact your cardiologist first to make sure it is okay to stop this drug. Side effects include rash, hives, and an increased risk of bleeding. Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, or ACE inhibitors, have been shown to help prevent future heart attacks and lower blood pressure. ACE inhibitors also help to maintain the normal shape of the heart after a heart attack so that you don't end up with a baggy heart that doesn't pump very well. For heart failure patients, ACE inhibitors make it easier for the heart to pump blood to the rest of the body. And finally, ACE inhibitors have been shown to protect the kidneys in patients with kidneys that don't work very well. ACE inhibitors can increase your potassium levels, so your doctor will do blood tests once in a while to check this. Because ACE inhibitors can lower your blood pressure, you may get lightheaded or dizzy when you get up from a lying position to a standing position. If this occurs, try sitting at the side of your bed for a few minutes before standing. This will give your body a chance to adjust to the change in position and pump more blood to your head. You may also experience a dry cough. If it becomes bothersome, speak to your doctor and they may change the drug to something else. If you get swelling of the lips, face, or throat, call 911 immediately. Beta blockers can be used to lower blood pressure. They also slow the heart rate, which helps prevent angina. Beta blockers have been shown to prevent future heart attacks, and in heart failure patients, can improve the pumping of the heart. Since beta blockers can lower blood pressure, you may experience lightheadedness or dizziness when you stand up. If this occurs, try to get up a little more slowly so that your body gets a chance to adjust and pump more blood to your brain. Because beta blockers slow your heart rate, you may find that you are more tired than usual. Be patient, as it may take about 2 weeks for your body to get used to the beta blocker. If you have diabetes, be aware that beta blockers may hide the signs of low blood sugars, except for sweating. Beta blockers can also aggravate asthma, but because beta blockers are so beneficial, your cardiologist will continue the beta blocker as long as your asthma can be controlled with puffers. The final drug that you will likely be taking is a class of cholesterol-lowering medication called statins. Statins lower LDL, which is the bad cholesterol that forms plaques in your arteries. Statins have been shown to prevent future heart attacks, decrease the likelihood of needing future procedures to open the coronary arteries, and it can also help to prevent strokes. It's also been thought that statins have anti-inflammatory properties and can stabilize plaques in the arteries, making them more difficult to rupture and cause a heart attack. The current cholesterol targets are total cholesterol less than 5.2, HDL, which is your good cholesterol, greater than 1, triglycerides less than 1.7, LDL less than 2, and total cholesterol to HDL ratio less than 4. Other cholesterol-lowering medications may be added to your statin if the cholesterol targets are not reached with statins alone. Side effects include muscle or joint pain. If it becomes bothersome, let your doctor know. Your doctor will also do blood tests once in a while to check how well your liver is functioning. Nitroglycerin comes in many forms. If you're using Eptra tablets that you are taking regularly every day, these are to help prevent angina. These agents may cause headaches. You can use Tylenol to help with the headaches, but if the headaches become unbearable, let your doctor know. Nitroglycerin spray or tablets that you dissolve under your tongue stop angina when you have an angina attack. Before you use your nitroglycerin spray, make sure you sit down or lean against a wall. Nitroglycerin can make you lightheaded, and we don't need you to fall down and break a hip while you're dealing with your angina. If it is a new bottle or you haven't used the spray in more than 14 days, you need to prime the container. You do this by facing the spray away from you and pumping the actuator until 4 sprays of nitroglycerin come out. Then use 1 spray on or under your tongue. If you're using tablets instead of the spray to stop angina, the tablets must be dissolved under the tongue to be absorbed. Wait 5 minutes. If you still have angina, use a second spray and wait 5 minutes. If you still have angina, you can take a third spray while you are calling 911. Nitroglycerin is not addictive, so you can use it as often as you need to. If you know an activity will cause angina, you can take a spray before you exert yourself to prevent the angina from occurring. Here are some tips to help you manage your medications. Circle the drugs you are taking in your book so that you can easily figure out which drugs you are taking. You are getting a lot of information at one time, so it's a good idea to review your discharge book regularly so it helps you remember why you are taking these medications. You are more likely to continue to take your medications if you understand why you are taking them. Use the same pharmacy for all your medications so that your pharmacist has a complete list of your prescription medications and they can tell you and your doctor if any of your medications should not be taken together. When you go home, your medications may not be the same drug or dose as you were on previously. Get your new prescription filled right away and take all your old medications to the pharmacy. The pharmacist will be able to tell you which ones to continue. the pharmacist can also take the medications you don't need anymore and discard them for you. Never stop a medication without letting your doctor know. Remember, they put you on the drug for a reason, so they might want to give you an alternative drug if you are having problems taking the ones you have been prescribed. Carry a current list of your medications with you so that you have a quick reference for medical appointments or if you ever end up in the emergency department. If you have trouble remembering to take your medications, try to time it around daily events, such as mealtimes or bedtime. You can purchase a pill organizer, such as a dosette, or have your pharmacy blister pack your medications for you. It's a good idea to keep a small supply of your medications in your handbag or office, just in case you forget to take your medications before you go to work. You can always talk to your doctor if you find that the dosing schedule is too difficult. Your doctor may be able to simplify your medications for you. Don't store your medications in hot or humid areas, such as the medicine cabinet in your bathroom or the glove compartment of your car. These kinds of conditions will shorten the expiry of your medications. If you ever have any questions, speak to your doctor or pharmacist.